Today, I'm going to design this icon that you can see on screen 4 times, but each time I'm only allowed to use the rectangle tool, the selection tools, and then one extra tool. Oh yeah, and the pen tool is completely off limits. So this is the first test of today's challenge, and they're going to get more difficult with each stage. But for the first one, I can only use the selection tools, the rectangle tool, and the pathfinder. So this shouldn't be too difficult at all, really. And so with the rectangle tool, I'm going to make a lengthy rectangle, and then duplicate it by holding down the Alt Option key. Remember, each stage in this challenge, I can only use the selection tools and the rectangle tool, plus one other tool. It should be interesting to see how far I can get along the 4 stages designing this icon. But now I have 5 bars. I'm going to duplicate one bar and hold down Shift and rotate it by 90 degrees. It's really easy to place this in position using the smart guides, and then I'm going to duplicate it across. Now everything is in position, it's time to use the Pathfinder, and I'm going to make use of the divide function, which essentially is going to cut everything up into sections. It's just a case of then removing the areas that I don't want to use, and bingo, stage 1 is complete. But yeah, it's going to get progressively more difficult. Now this time I'm going to use rectangles that are only strokes, and then build the design up like I did previously. But for this second stage, I'm only going to use the shape builder tool, plus the selection tools and the rectangle tools, and that shouldn't be too difficult, but maybe just a tiny bit more inconveniencing than the pathfinder tool. Now with the selection highlighted, I can press Shift and M, which is the shape builder tool, and then click and draw along the sections that I want to unite. Finally, I'm going to hold down the Alt Option key and then remove the areas that I don't want, i.e. the inner sections. And that's pretty much done. All I need to do now is press Shift and X to flick the strokes over to a fill. And there you have it, stage 2 complete. But this is where things are going to get quite a bit more difficult. Adobe Illustrator has a tool known as the blob brush tool, and when you draw with it, it creates a section like so that's turned into a vector automatically. So for this test, I'm going to use this tool and the selection tools only. That's right, no rectangle tool in use. Now you might have noticed that this tool, the blob brush tool, is rounded, but if I double click the tool in the toolbar, I can bring up some settings. I can reduce the brush to a razor thin edge, and I can also change the direction as well, which might come in handy. So yeah, I do think I can make the icon design using the blob brush tool alone. So I need to hold down Shift so I can perfectly draw a straight line. Now I've gone ahead and set up those 5 bars, I realize that I can't use the Pathfinder tool or the Shape Builder tool, and that's what I normally use to cut out the middle section. So I'm going to need to figure something out to get around that. So I'm going to use one of the bars to set up the thickness for the middle gap, and then line up 2 different rectangles perfectly in the center. So okay, that looks pretty good. Now it's just a case of duplicating a rectangle to position on the left, and then line it up properly. The thing is that the design is going to be made up of many different shapes, and they're not joined together because I can't use the Pathfinder tool. However, I could adjust the blob brush tool so it's horizontally adjusted, and then draw in a section that will actually join parts of the design together. But the issue here is that it's nearly impossible to line up properly. As you can see here, this section is now joined together, but I'm pretty sure if I zoomed in, the edges wouldn't be flush and perfect. But yeah, I've technically done it, and it was pretty tricky. The last stage, stage 4, is going to be pretty testing. So for this stage, I can only use the shaper tool and the selection tools. And so here is the shaper tool, and it's really quite silly actually. So I first need a rectangle, but with this tool, you need to make shapes that have the ends overlapping and intersecting. It is pretty fiddly and pretty annoying to use, as you can see. But now the four lines are finally set up, I need to drill over the corners to unite everything. And it is really awkward just using it for a workflow, but I think it might be possible to actually finish the icon with this tool. Now I have five of the bars ready. I could just duplicate one to make the sides, but let's make things a bit more difficult, why not? I'm only going to use this as a guide, and then I'm going to draw in another box with the horrible shaper tool. I actually have to move it off of the design because if I use the shaper tool to unite the corners, it's going to interact with the other part of the design. But yeah, this tool is really, really annoying to work with, and I suggest you lot just try it out for yourself just to know what I'm talking about here. It's really, really, really weird. After duplicating the shapes, I remade the middle section to incorporate that gap, and that was the design created four times using a different tool each and every time. Do make sure to subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content, and also click one of the videos on screen if you want to brush up on your skills or learn something new today. But until next time, design your future today. Peace.